And Lepore, what can you say about Auston Matthews? I mean, he now has 10 goals in 11 games, leads the National Hockey League in goals. He is the best five-on-five goal scorer since the second he stepped into this league.
It's not even close.
I mean, he's just on another level, man. I mean, we talk all the time about how great Connor McDavid is. And sure, they do play a different style of game. But man, when it comes to putting the puck in the net, this dude is just, I mean, he's the best in the league right now.
Yeah, he really is. And the thing about Matthews is that, well, you touched on it, that he scores 5-on-5. And I don't think you can even put into words the value of that. It's all about like the metrics and, again, the word value of like those types of goals and the importance of them. And I'm sure if we pulled out the numbers where, okay, guys who score a lot on the power play, if they were replaced on a very good power play unit, maybe a lesser of a player doesn't score as many goals as that elite player, but they still score often and get a lot of points because they're playing on the power play. Whereas 5-on-5, it is what it is. You're exposed. So to me, if there's an underrated stat or if there are underrated stats, it's 5-on-5 stats. And it goes back into his contract too, because when he got that number, the $11.65 million, we all knew deep down that, okay, he's not going to get McDavid's 12.5. But then I think what came on the other end of it was Eichel's 10. And we saw that $10 million that Eichel was getting, and we kind of assumed, okay, Austin's going to be in the middle. So we're like, he's going to get the 10.5 or the 11. And I think a lot of Leafs fans, when we saw the 11.65, we kind of thought, is that a little too high? Like, we knew we didn't get hosed on it, but we all kind of thought maybe that's a little too high. But then you look at those 5-on-5 numbers, and now you see him coming of age as a player, and he is dominating. Like, no one is questioning any nickel and dime of that contract now, in the way that when he's out there, he's dominant. The guys I compare him to, and I'm not saying he's better than these guys, but the guys I compare him to are Mario Lemieux and Eric Lindros, in the way of, number one, he's a center, but number two, the physical gifts he has. Guys that have that type of size, that type of reach, the kind of talent they have, as well as the hands. So in a sense, like, they can physically do it all. He's a rare breed of player. He's a special player. If he has a long career with the Toronto Maple Leafs, he'll most likely retire as the best Maple Leaf we've ever seen. And again, like, we should be lucky to have him. It's one of those things that sometimes we're in the moment and we don't realize how good things are. But Auston Matthews is a once-in-a-lifetime player, and he plays for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So those not watching on YouTube, I can't help but smile right now. But I've pumped the tires of Auston Matthews quite a bit. What do you think, Bruno?
No, I mean, I couldn't agree more. And you made a really good point about just the size and skill combination. And it's so, so rare, because you look at a guy even like Crosby, right? He's like 5'10", 5'11", and the things he's able to do. Matthews is 6'3", 215, 220. And to see what he's able to do with that size and the hands and the shooting ability and the 200-foot game that I've been so impressed with.
Oh, it's got so much better this year.
It's unbelievable. And that's one thing that kind of pisses me off when I see people on Twitter or, you know, just hearing from other fans and things like that about how, you know, Matthews isn't great in his own end and blah, blah, blah. He still needs to take another step defensively. But if you've been watching this guy closely, especially over the last couple of years, his ability to just strip guys of the puck, when he just goes into corners and he lifts the stick, steals the puck, and he's going the other way before you even know it. And I don't think he gets enough credit for how good he is defensively and how developed his 200-foot game is at this point.
Yeah.
And just going back to the goal-scoring ability, I mean, it's just on another level from anyone in the game right now, besides basically Ovechkin and Pasternak. I mean, we're truly watching a guy who could go down as one of the top 10 goal scorers in the history of the sport.
Oh yeah.
That's how highly I think of him. And just watching him, never mind on a game by game basis, Lepore, a shift by shift basis, his ability to just generate offense. And it, I'm not saying he goes out there and he's scoring every shift, but he's creating things in the offensive zone almost every single time he's out there, where he has this ability to turn nothing into something.
Yeah, like you're waiting for it when you're watching him. Like you're kind of sitting up just waiting for it, like either him to dish it for a shot or him for him to shoot it himself. Yeah.
Like there are times where a play is not even there and you're like, oh, okay, they're just going to kind of call it a shift here and get a change. And then Matthews will just strip some of the puck, center it into the middle of the ice, and they get a scoring chance.
Yeah.
Or he'll just come out of the corner with the puck and get a shot on net. Like, I mean, it's just the talent level is off the charts. And it's like you said, we are so lucky that this guy is a member of the Leafs right now. It's unbelievable.